In this video, we'll walk through the installation of the Pi Integrator for Esri ArcGIS Data Relay. The Data Relay is a Windows service, and we are going to begin by downloading the install kit for the Data Relay from the Pi Integrator for Esri ArcGIS configuration portal. And the configuration portal, we walked through the installation in the previous video. If you're unfamiliar with the architecture pieces used and the data flow, you can check out our architecture full details video, which is going to make sure that you're familiar with the terms that we're going to be using during the installation and configuration. And if you don't have the configuration portal installed, you can go back and check the previous video for that as well. This is the machine that I'm going to be installing the data relay to. And it's very important in a production environment that the data relay be installed on its own separate machine. And that's because of the resources it needs making calls to the Pi system. It is also, as a result, very important to minimize the latency between your Pi system and your data relay. I previously installed the configuration portal on this other machine, and this is the machine that I'm installing the data relay to. It's also important to note that the data relay has to be in a domain which trusts the domain where the configuration portal is and is trusted by the Pi AF server's domain. In my case, my Pi AF server, my configuration portal, and my data relay are all in the same domain, so it's very easy to satisfy that requirement. Additionally, the Pi system that the data relay is going to be accessing has to have the Pi Data Archive version 3.4.390 or later, as well as the Pi AF server 2.5 or later, with version 2.6 being the recommended one for the Pi AF server. And finally, when it comes to the Pi system security, OSIsoft recommends that the Data Relay Windows service account run under a dedicated service account. And I will be following this recommendation, and as a result, I have to make sure that that account has the appropriate read access to my Pi system. So the first thing I'm going to be doing is I will navigate to my configuration portal. So the FQDN and then PyGeo portal. And I'm going to enter the credentials of this user. And my user account here is part of the PyGeo admins user group on the configuration portal machine, which is why I'm going to be able to install and configure the data relay. So we saw that there are errors that need your attention, and this means that essentially, if we take a look, reminding us that the data relay is unavailable. To download the install kit for the data relay, I'm going to go to Administration and then Data Relay. And go ahead and use this to download the latest. And you can see the prerequisite and instructions here. And I'm going to go ahead and save this to the install kits folder. And the data relay is also available in the OSIsoft Tech Support Download Center as well. Okay, the install kit has been successfully downloaded. Another important consideration before we begin the installation is that the relay port, which is port 5464 by default, be open on the data relay machine. It needs to be open to the inbound connections from the configuration portal machine. So I have already gone ahead and taken care of making sure that port 5464 is open. And lastly, you should only install one data relay for each Pi Integrator for Esri ArcGIS instance, so only one is allowed. Okay, now I'm going to navigate to the folder where the install kit was just downloaded to. My installing user is C. Metzinger, and I'm going to be running it as an administrator, and the user is in the local administrators group that I'm installing it with. You can hit OK if you want to extract the files to the default folder, or you can select a specific folder if you want to extract the files to. And with that, I'll go ahead and start the wizard. If you're installing this on a clean machine, as I am, these first several dialog boxes are for the prerequisites and then the Pi AF client setup. The first choice to make is for the installation directories. If you only have the C drive on the machine that you're installing the data relay to, you can go ahead and hit next. If you are segmenting your applications on different drives from your operating system, as I am doing, you can go ahead and change the drive location. I'll hit next. Then you need to provide the default Pi server, which is now called the Pi Data Archive. And I'm going to also provide the name of the Pi AF server. At this point, we'll go through the installation for the Pi AF client tool, Pi System Explorer. I'm going to go ahead and participate in the Pi System Customer Experience Improvement Program and hit next. And next. And I'm receiving this warning because Microsoft Excel is not installed on this machine, so Pi Builder will not be installed. And now the data relay setup wizard is initiated. You can go ahead and hit next. If you did that previously, I'm going to match the install destination folder with that of the SDK components earlier. Next, I'll need to choose the service account. It is recommended to use a custom account, a service account that is created specifically for the Pi data relay. I do have a custom domain account, and so that's what I'm going to be using here. And I'll go ahead and validate. And before I hit next, I just want to emphasize that this custom account has been given read access to the Pi AF server and database and AF elements within that database, as well as on the Pi Data Archive, read access to the PiPoint database, as well as point security and data security for any tags that are mapped to AF attributes that I'm interested in exposing to the Esri platform. If these security settings aren't given, then the data relay won't be able to see anything or even possibly connect to anything. I'll go ahead and hit next. And now I need to provide the portal identity. And the portal identity can be identified looking at the configuration portal. So here under the data relay, the application pool ID is what you should use for the configuration portal. So I've added that identity right here, and I'll install. Okay, so the data relay has been successfully installed, and after installing the data relay, there's just a couple things on the configuration portal that we'll do next. So in the configuration portal, under the data relay tab, we're going to need to provide the host name where the data relay is located. So this is the machine name. I'll go ahead and update that. And you can see after I've updated that and installed the data relay, I now see this message that my data relay is running and it's identified the node. At this point, the configuration portal is installed, the data relay is installed, and the only other items that need to be done for the configuration portal and data relay are under the Administration System tab. The endpoints for the Pi Coresight servers and the Esri ArcGIS GeoEvent processors are specified here. Pi Coresight is not required for the Pi Integrator for Esri ArcGIS. It's something that can be used because there's an integration possible with Pi Coresight. And so if you have the Pi Coresight server available, you can use it for that. I do, and so I'm going to go ahead and add a Pi Coresight server. I'll give it a name and a description as well. For the endpoint, I'll need to specify the URL that is used for Coresight. And this is how I access my Pi Coresight server. Next, it is definitely a requirement to configure a Esri ArcGIS GeoEvent processor, since that is a necessary component in the data flow. And one thing to just note, the ArcGIS GeoEvent processor is going to be renamed in the next release of Esri's to the ArcGIS GeoEvent extension for server. I'm going to go ahead and add this, give it a name and description as well. And for the endpoint, this is the URL that's used to access the Esri ArcGIS GeoEvent Processor Manager. And HTTPS is absolutely required here. And to access the GeoEvent Processor Manager, there's normally another /GeoEvent/Manager, but the necessary portion is up to the port, and that's exactly what I have specified right here. So with that, my Pi Integrator for Esri ArcGIS configuration portal is installed and configured along with the data relay. And the next videos focus on the creation of feature services to bring specific Pi system data into the Esri ArcGIS platform.